In terms of overall average destruction.
But we're starting it off with the captain himself, Rigo Torres, for top of Aya Empire, starting with a Queen Charge Dragon Rider, not coming in with the Lalo, but did sneak in a few rocket loons and balloons to help potentially target and help pull some Seeking Air Mines for the Queen's healers. The healer, the headhunters do come off to the Queen, but easy. Down goes the headhunters, did not even have to sweat, and now the Queen is going to take her time through the Lava Hound. But what we did learn from when Judo broke down one of the attacks is when you use the poison spell, drop it on your Queen, not the Lava Hound, because the pups will perfectly surround the Queen, so that is exactly how you can take down the Lava Hound pups super quick.
Top and I Empire is full with players who achieved the rare one and done last year, picking up their golden ticket on the only entry that they had into the world's qualifying setup. That golden ticket now just within their reach once again, having missed qualification the first season. They are back in full force and ready to march on to face off in the upper bracket against another one of their old foes that we just got to see. As they make their way toward the town hall, though, Rigo Torres setting up the funnel for this big strike, which is now being deployed on the bottom left side over on that corner. Gonna get an opportunity to have an early hit against an air defense and an Eagle Artillery, Carbon.
He pops that Warden ability. Headhunters are actually protected from the Warden Eternal Tome, getting through the enemy king. Then they're gonna move through the enemy Royal Champion with his Royal Champion under rage. But the beautiful thing was his Queen somehow just narrowly dodged the Tallow Poison so she could keep up her momentum moving through that compartment, because it is super dangerous sending the Queen through the Town Hall Poison, especially through the charge. But the Royal Champion clears the Air Skellies. More Air Skellies come up, and that's what we talked about before, is Dark Spuzan knows that Tampanai Empire loves Queen Charge Lalo Air Attacks. So Air Skellies could be a huge thing that they're... Look, another set of Air Skellies. Three Air Skellies coming down the space, but it's not going to be enough. Rigo Torres coming in with the 3-star for Tampanai Empire.
Deftly dodging defenses and neutralizing traps, a performance worthy of Ocean's 11 or even a Mission Impossible.
The Dragon Riders were on the left side grabbing all that. Now we have Ty of Darkest Luzon, but the key stat that we have to keep our eye out here, I mean, just for saying this, I think I'm going to jinx him, but he went perfect in the pre-qualifiers. He's trying to replicate Ast of Alternate Techs, who went 11 for 11 last qualifiers. Let's see if Ty can stay perfect and trying to do it here with his first attack in the qualifiers here today for Darkest Design.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Carmen. And not only did he have a perfect run through the pre-qualifiers with seven three-star hits, he was the only player to do so. And last time, like you mentioned, Alternate Attacks had a player of that caliber. They got a golden ticket. Will Darkest Muzan be able to run it back again? I think the story is being written in front of our very eyes. Cracking in straight to the town hall, a tornado trap will go off, but it doesn't pull the Electro Dragons. That's going to be an easy zap with the Rage and Freeze added on top to grab that first star. Second's going to be coming in shortly thereafter, but a quick freeze onto the center target, multi-target Inferno. Will that be enough to take it down? The Seeking Air Mine explodes, and that multi-Inferno will survive, Carbon.
Woody, I can't take my eyes off watching him play. Do you notice what he's doing? He's playing with one hand. He's holding the device in one, playing with the other. I have to put my device down and use both my hands to even concentrate on this. But incredible job coming in. He still is a Royal Champion. She's going through the core of this base, has a freeze, another rage, an invisibility. Can he continue this momentum? But he's losing all his dragons and he needs to get through this defending king though.
With the dexterity of a concert pianist, Ty's fingers flick across the screen with a rapidity surprising even the most experienced casters that you have here up on the desk. But this final force be enough? He's got that brand new snaky Archer Queen slithering in through the right side, finishing off that Barb King. You know, there's not any big, huge defenses that remain to stop her, but just a lot of point fire on the backside that I think is going to ultimately stack up and finish her off. Unicorn will try to keep her healthy, but there's just not enough firepower.
I can't blame you at all for what happened, not getting a 3-star. You can put all the blame on me for jinxing you. I did indeed, unfortunately. Oh, with only 26 seconds left, is he going to have enough to... Would he have the time? The queen and the unicorn, unfortunate. And this is going to be his first fail of the qualifiers, which is going to put him at a big disadvantage because Riga Torres of Tampanai Empire did start off with that 3-star.
Well, it's going to be a heartbreaker for Darkest Muzan, but won't put them ultimately too far behind. A 2-star in the 90% is a very good hit by any... Yep, the sun is rising for Tampanai Empire. A new name, but the same great flavor you've come to love from this squad of guys. We're going to have a relatively well-protected town hall near the center in a kind of an anti-2-star setup here from Manta. Almolin chose to respond with mass drags, and it's going to throw one Dragon Rider in there just for good measure. Lightning strikes from the sky. Opor on the top left side doesn't quite finish off the Arch Queen, but knocks down a few key targets there. I'm guessing he's going to swoop in from the bottom left around that 7 o'clock position to finish off the Eagle Artillery and then continue on up. But, oh no, maybe he'll go from the top side anyways, Carbon.
Well, the Queen can get some value from up there. Notice where the sweepers are pointing from... kind of away from the Eagle Artillery, meaning that could be an ideal location to send your dragons. He does have the blimp to use. Bamu Allen did note that his favorite attack strategy was the Zap Dragons, and that's exactly what he's doing right here.
Yeah, you made a really good point about those sweepers being positioned pretty strongly to deny attacks from the bottom corner here. It just makes me a bit concerned about what's going to happen with this Eagle Artillery. A real big tack still sticking right up at the back end of this base. Almolin's going to have to try to avoid stepping on that. But with dragons, I think he should have a good shot at it. But he will be going in from the bottom left corner anyways. Keep an eye on that air defense in the center. Didn't manage to crack in through to get it down. But with a well enough spread of dragons, he should be able to get at least some of them to punch through.
Yeah, he's got these dragons coming in. At least he can take down this Eagle Artillery nice and quick. But his queen did take out the defending queen, which is a brilliant, really nice value. Oh. But the dragons are trying to push their way in towards the middle. Here comes the blimp. He has two more rages to use with him. He can still pop this Warden Internal Tome here.
He's actually threaded the needle beautifully, not even triggering the air sweepers at all. Rage spell right as they're about to get right into the thick of it. Dragons in the bottom corner go down, but there's still... I think 5 or 6 left still in the core. Takes out the town hall, and they're now spreading out. Big pop, though, as the balloons are finished up. Needs to knock these infernos out ASAP. He finally has managed to do it, but what's remaining on the backside of the base? An air defense goes down thanks to a huge swing from the barbed sword, and if these dragons can finish off the top corner, I think he might have a chance at a 3-star.
This is looking fantastic with just over 40 seconds left. The king's on the backside and helps clear the outside. Dragon Rider just about to go down, but he's got 4 dragons up and plenty. Only 2 more buildings down goes now the final Wizard Tower, and another 3-star for Tampanai Empire. Amualan, what a great Zap Dragon triple right there.
Great reminder from Spicy Potato over in chat. Once you get a visit to Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory, you want to get right back in there. They've got their eyes on another golden ticket, and it's looking very likely that Tampanai Empire will be advancing through the top bracket. Darkest Muzan not able to deny them a 3-star with either of those first 2 strikes. Congratulations to them so far. They have got to be feeling high and mighty.
Yeah, Tampanai Empire coming through right now, looking fantastic. Darkest Muzan can still turn this run around. We've seen it before, where teams have put back-to-back triples, and then the enemy has gotten 2 fails, but have made a comeback, but it's rare. It is insanely difficult. But now, will Darkest Muzan take the risks? Will they do attacks which leave the town hall for the end? We'll have to wait and see. But now is Wei coming in with the Queen Charge Dragon Riders. Wei is the 2019 World MVP, winning it with tons of other players that are in the qualifiers here today, but he's focused right now on taking down Machua's base.
Not just a competitor on the world scene, but the most valuable player from any squad. He has been to the highest mountains, and he has seen in the distance villages aplenty, All of them have been destroyed. Wei is a three-star expert from the very highest level of the Clash scene. Expect great things from him in this attack as it's getting set up now. He's going in with the Dragon Rider's new attack strat, which has shown quite a bit of success so far today, Carbon. Carving a hole through the bottom corner with this queen charge and taking his time against a base that's relatively spread out and difficult to reach through. He's not going to have too much in terms of spell support for the back end, but what's standing out to you?
Biggest thing I'm seeing is sending this king for that town hall. Some Teslas did pop. Hopefully the king does loop his way into the town hall here. Since the world champion, a Tesla farm seems to have popped up over at the right side. So nice job of using the world champion to help clear this. But he's going to wall bring again. This queen can get some insane value. As long as he focuses on this king, he's got an invisibility spell. But look at all these skellies popping up near the town hall, Woody.
Really distracting that poor king. He pops that Iron Fist ability and is smashing as many of them as he can. He's got a big coterie of followers to try to help his way through. Oh, the freeze at the last second.
Man.
Allowed him to get a few more strikes off there. Tornado Trap slowing up that Royal Champion, but the first star has been claimed. Second one will come in tow shortly thereafter. Wei is now focusing the entirety of his attack over on the left corner here. And the dragons are soaring on in. Riding up on top and spreading fire all across the land. They target directly onto enemy defenses, and boy, are there still a lot of them left. Eagle Artillery has been pummeling away this entire time, but it's about to be neutralized. Can't even target anything if it's getting too close. Last big defense there is that scatter shot, which you see highlighted now, Carbon.
Yeah, the scatter shot needs to go down, but the queen, what wall are you going for? Go for the scatter shot, queen. He's got just a few Dragon Riders left getting hit by the air defense on the top side. Luckily, the Royal Champ was able to take the Town Hall down, and the Warden helps assist the Dragon Riders on the AD. And this Dragon Rider, yes, the Scatter goes down. He can actually use a Wall Break to help on the Archer Tower to help damage it, to take it down. Wait a second, is he going to use it? Yes, there it is. Super Wall Breaker helped take it down. It damages, and the Warden with the Dragon Rider down it goes, but now it's time. Oh, no.
The Archer Queen has pivoted to three different wall segments, four different wall segments within this one compartment, and is just not going to be there to help out on the back end. And that is going to leave Wei just ever so short. 98% two-star for Darkest Muzan, and it feels like now it is their darkest hour. Two-stars up against Tompadai Empire, picking up back-to-back triples. This is really not going way the way that Wei had been hoping, Carmen.
I was going to say it's really not going his way indeed.
Oh, my God. We should be canned just for resorting to this pun.
Oh, man. Unfortunate, the two back-to-back two stars there, getting a 98% with the Queen Charge Dragon Riders. And again, it comes down to what we talked about before, the time fails. And it's happening quite a bit with the Dragon Riders. You got to start those Dragon Riders early enough to be able to push your way through. But if you start too early, maybe the Queen doesn't get that value and you keep them alive. But now we're focused on Machuo for Tompadai Empire, looking to come in with his own version of the Queen Charge Dragon Riders.
I like that we see a little bit of variation among the players showing off different skill sets and angles of attack for this Skybreed army. Dragon Riders certainly getting a lot of love from the players here today. Maybe not the most played strat, but certainly the most played new strat since their release just a few short weeks ago. Machuo encountering some ice golems here out of the CC, meant to slow things down, but fortunately for him, he's managed to keep them on the far outer edge where there aren't any defenses to fire away at that Archer Queen, slowing things up, but shouldn't ultimately be too much of a problem for him.
Yeah, we did talk with Machuo before about asking what was his greatest accomplishment for Clash of Clans, and his response was finishing third in global, and hopefully today he can change, or if he makes it tomorrow day too, they can change that to making it to Worlds for 2021 and competing on the grand stage with all the eyes on you and trying to get that golden ticket, joining alternate attacks. But this is the attack he's focused on, trying to take down Wei, charges this queen into the Eagle Artillery. As long as this king can stay on the right side, he can get that multi-target inferno all the way over there.
It takes a huge amount of practice to stay at the top of your game, and Metro is a guy who knows a lot about that. 20 attacks every day to stay sharp in training. Clash of Clans may have been out for many, many years, but it starts to feel like a brand new game with every big balance change update presenting new opportunities, every new troop creating new attack compositions, and Metruo certainly knows how to keep it fresh. Grabs the first couple stars here, but has got a long haul slog to go through with just a minute left for the back end of the space. I feel like he might have been a little bit too slow on the strike here, Carbon Finn.
Yeah, the biggest issue was the start of the raid with that blimp not taking out the Town Hall, and it forced the Dragon Riders to go through it. Remember, since the blimp dies on a Town Hall, it does activate it with the death damage, but not enough there. Now, the Dragon Riders were supposed to charge away to the different side of the base. Does have the Queen ability still intact. The enemy Queen did go down, but the King is stalling up those Headhunters, which is not too good. But the problem is, these Dragon Riders split off, and the air defense on the top side is going to do way too much damage, and this is going to be the defense that Darkest Muzan needed.
You are certainly right to point out that blimp. I think my eyes were on a completely different segment of the base, but that did wind up taking a big chunk of his offensive resources off of the table and delay him quite a bit here. Still, Tomp and I Empire are going to be far and ahead with their two triples, the two-star 83%. Is going to be a dip down, but certainly something from which they could still recover and maintain their lead.
Yeah, they've got the three stars from Rigatoris and Amualan with the Queen Charge Dragon Riders and the Zap Dragons, so they're looking strong, but Darkest Muzan needs to turn it around. The solid defense from Wei, only holding Machuo to an 83% two-star. That's fantastic when these pros are absolutely need. If they fail, they need to be failing in the high 90s, really, at this stage of the competition. We've seen really strong defenses from previous matches, including Team Elevate, but Darkest Muzan is looking to do that exactly here against Tomp and I Empire.
Well, we're now halfway through this war, Tomp and I, with 2 out of 3 hits, pulling up the triples. It seems like so far, Carbon, the storyline here has been really strong teams emerging from the early stage of this bracket, NY Amazing and Tomp and I Empire, but really only Tomp and I Empire able to keep the momentum going forward. Really heavy defenses set up by Team Elevate took them to the lead in the last round, but Darkest Muzan just doesn't seem to be able to present as much of an obstacle yet.
Yeah, we're going to have to see what they can do, but the thing is GUI breaking in towards the top side, the Rocket Loons up top, and the Tesla Farm for Amualan seems to be trying to protect this Eagle Artillery. But I think the Teslas also would, and they actually did, stop and take down that air defense, not allow you to take out the air defense so easily, since now the Queen was able to grab that. Dragons are down. Look at this. Dragons are down really early. The Queen does loop her way back into the Eagle Artillery. Did he want the Queen, though, to walk and follow behind the King? That's the question. He's still saving out of this blimp, Woody. He frees up the Queen and needs to continue this charge through the base.
Ready to smack that Berserk button as soon as he gets back toward the Town Hall. He's already got a Battle Blimp straight on that big target. The second star about to be claimed immediately after the first one. And a big spread out of this base could be trouble if he can't get his forces concentrated.
Oh, no.
They're kind of spread out at this point, Carbon.
Oh, the sneaky goblins. The Blimp found the Tornado Trap, not able to take the Town Hall down. He still is the world champion to use. Those builders are trying to repair the Town Hall here. Dragon Riders need to help assist, but unfortunately, the Sneaky Goblin Tornado Trap was in the perfect spot for that blimp. He didn't send it over the dragons, which is typically what you tend to see. But hey, the Tornado Trap stalled up and stopped the Sneaky Goblins, and he could have used the Royal Champion in a different compartment of this base.
Great base building there from Amualan, protecting the Town Hall with a couple of builder's huts. And, you know, ultimately, that's not going to save the Town Hall in the end, but it might force out a panic drop from an attacker who realizes that if Plan A didn't follow through, you might need to have a disproportionate response against that Town Hall to ensure that you don't get the disaster one star. So does manage to recover that in the bottom right corner, but Darkest Muzan fail yet again. On their quest for the triple. Tomp and I Empire with 2 already in the bank just means that they need to coast through and keep the defenses strong. but this is looking like a match that our second seed team did not see coming.
Yeah, Darkest Muzan came in very strong from the pre-qualifiers and not showing up here right now. But remember, it is double elimination. You still have a second chance if you lose, meaning that whoever loses this match will go down into the lower bracket to be fighting for their lives so they don't get eliminated. Because today, we will be eliminating two teams, meaning we do have two more matches after this, so don't go anywhere. We're taking a look at the post-attack stats. Only the 83% two stars, and Darkest Muzan is still looking for their first triple.
Well, a lot to be learned. If you are a fan of the new Dragon Rider troop, even seeing some use of the rocket balloons as well, particularly to target onto defenses well buried deep within the base. But I think that the bigger lesson that I'm starting to pick up on here is the complexity of the defensive prowess shown by these teams. You know, you don't get to see your enemy's base until just a short time before you have to plan your attack to finish it off. But you have a lot of time in the lead up to these matches to do everything you possibly can to get your own bases designed to the best of your ability. I think that with the performance so far from Team Elevate and with Tampa and I Empire now holding off, not even getting tripled a single time so far, there's going to be a lot of bases shared around in the wake of this round.
Absolutely, but we do know that a lot of times some players may actually be reusing some bases, surprising enough, and all they do is move some traps around, so you kind of get into the head of your opponent running the exact same base. Do you think they move traps? Do they bait a certain entry? You got to really take that into account. We saw from the previous qualifiers, and will we see it here today or even tomorrow? But this queen is looking to get her charge, does not have a jump, meaning he can still use this super wall breaker, has it perfectly open. Maybe he waits for the queen to take out the king platform to target, or you could even just drop the wall breaker from about 9 o'clock to try to target the builder hut to continue. Oh, wait, no, he opened. Where's it going? Traps? No, it doesn't make it, Woody. Oh, the super wall breaker now goes to the builder hut. Tries to open this so the queen can continue her push to grab this multi-target inferno. What do you want to see if this queen can get that value?
She's on a long path, but gets the CC pull out there, and it's going to be slowed up even more. We just got a minute and 22 left, and I got to be wondering, what is the like game plan here for these attackers relying on like minute and a half queen charges to get damage in there? The cleanup has just time and again been the big factor that has stopped these attacks from being successful. So ultimately, let's take a look over at the top now, where Michael DP has one single minute to try to get these Dragon Riders on task. He drops a rage spell. He's got another one waiting in the wings, a couple of freezes to shut down these defenses, but it is going to be a blitzkrieg if he can make it all the way to the end and get that triple.
Yeah, a single target inferno actually locked onto the Royal Champion to force her ability, and down she goes. Used that freeze way too late, unfortunately. She could have been still alive. He does have an invisibility spell. And is it going to be enough? There is a ground expo. We do have some Teslas, but he's only got 30 seconds left, Woody.
Not going to be enough, I'm fearing. Even though he's got plenty for cleanup on the outer edges, he did not take seriously enough time as a factor, the final boss in any cleanup. Time. 14 seconds left. He's going to send in the last sneaky goblin and an archer to try to get some additional forces concentrated on the back outer side. Unfortunately, that gold store is still going to be up.
Wait,
hold on. Can
three,
you get the forces on
two,
there? Did we call
one,
it too soon?
Yo!
What is
he
that?
Got it! The three
an incredible
star!
Showing from Michael DP. I'm spelling out doom in my head. I had to give him the reverse jinx. You know, I've been jinxing so many attacks. I figured I might as well throw him a loop there, Carbon.
He was able to clean it up, and perfectly, the Dragon Riders finished that off. They were just there. Queen grabbed the mortar, which allowed the Dragon Riders to retarget, turn around, and go for the storage to finish this off, which now puts Tomp and I at a huge advantage over Darkest Muzan.
Well, I think a lot of the best stories out there in the Clash world have a surprise ending. And for me, that was a surprise. I genuinely thought that he was going to run out of time. But When it came down to it, plenty of DPS, no more defending structures, managed to have the troops like virtually perfectly spread out. Kind of unimaginable how it all collapsed in the end, but managed to get it done. Hats off to you. And with that, Tompanai Empire on their third 3-star have virtually guaranteed advancement in the upper bracket.
Now we're seeing Situ coming in for Darkest Muzan with his own version of the Drag Bat. What kind of value can he get? Because one of his kind of favorite attacks is using some of the dragons to push their way through, but he's got the dragons down. Look at this, right off the bat, he's not waiting around, and he's going in with not even, it seems like 20 seconds in the raid, and he's got almost his whole army down.
This is just bonkers attack styles. Situ has seen so many hits that have gone with a time fill at the end, and he's like, that is not going to happen to me. But at what cost? He's really flipped the script on its head and is trying to do everything he can to get his forces on the board, applying maximum firepower. But will his supply lines be cut in the end, or can he keep this crazy train going? Lots of spells to support, but the dragons are slowly going down one by one. It's going to be bats for the attempted cleanup at the end, but I'm seeing 3-4 Witcher Towers still standing. The bane of the existence of any bat army, Carbon.
Yeah, the Eagle Achille finally goes down. Where is he going to deploy this Royal Champion? Because the dragons are going, the single target Inferno. Now we got to look at how much splash is left. We've got 1, 2 Wizard Towers. We have a Scattershot. We've got a Royal Champion, but he's got 4 free spells. So if he times this right, he has a chance here, Woody.
Well, I've certainly learned my lesson about counting any attacker out too soon. He drops the first free spell. Second one is out now to protect as the bats path right over. They manage to take it out without taking any fire on their own. Oh, what? The world champion's drawing fire! Doesn't need to use the third free spell there! The bats are going crazy, Carbon!
The perfect spell placement right there. The royal champion didn't even go down. And now it's clean up and he's got a minute left in his swag freeze at that. What?
Beautiful perfect hit from Darkest Muzan, and the first 3-star we have seen from them. They are certainly down, but are giving themselves every single opportunity to continue moving on. The triple there brings their star total up to 9, still a deficit of 2 relative to Tompanai Empire, but if they have any chance at all by the skin of their teeth to pull it off, it will be because they were able to put up another 3-star thanks to Situ.
Yeah, now they're looking to hold a 1-star defense. 1-star is what they need from Tompanai Empire. Is that likely? Not likely at all. We haven't seen a 1-star yet today. We've seen a close risky attack. Well, actually, no, we have. We have. KOG did because of the log launch, I remember, with the Hog Riders.
Right.
So will we see that from Tompanai is going to be the question. And I just need to be going for the 2-stars. And they could be advancing to day number 2.
Heavy-handed hit from Situ. Really big investment in that early smack. It's sort of a one-hit KO type move. It's the haymaker. It's the Hail Mary. It's the big toss from all the way backfield. But when it goes off without a hitch, you are rewarded handsomely for it. Let's switch things over to React now, where Tompanai Empire have an opportunity to seal the deal and close it out with just the 2-star. React himself has a 63% hit rate, so expect great things from him. And as you mentioned, that doesn't include a 1-star anywhere in the realm of possibility.
No, he's looking to help secure. He can grab the town hall potentially with a blimp. He's got 1 lightning, 4 headhunters. That may come out unless he switches it up to a stone slammer. Where's his RC going? He's got 1 invisibility spell. Luckily, the last he got locked down by the single target Inferno, but get ready for that invisibility spell. Yes, but is the RC gonna... Oh no, RC, where are you going? Oh, she does lock onto the single. Down it goes, and also takes down the sweeper at that.
Still making his way through the bottom side of the base. There we go with the battle blimp, making a beeline for the town hall. Two stars will guarantee advancement for Tom and I, and they are just mere seconds away from pulling it off. The repeat victory over Darkest Muzan, having been able to trounce them on the world stage just at the previous world's competition, it looks like they are poised to do it yet again. First star is claimed, Carbon Thin, and the second to come in right afterwards. There we go. Top and I Empire, 48% on the community vote, but the pick from both of us, and they indeed will be moving on. The storyline here as it's shaping up, though, is four clans that had majority Chinese membership all being sent down to the lower bracket. The two remaining teams in the upper bracket are the other squads from outside of China.
Look at his spells. He has a lightning, two freezes, and a haste left over. This seemed like he was hitting a Town Hall 13 base at that, finding some red air bombs in the middle. And the ice hound didn't even explode, which would have been another freeze spell, pretty much coming from the death damage. Has four balloons, a baby. React, you absolutely crushed GUI's base right there.
Just stomping him right in the face. So many swag troops and spells left. He's leaving me speechless, Carbon Finn. He could drop any more that he wanted to finish it off in time, but this is just his victory lap now. React knows he's got plenty of time, so why not swagger off with the final
right?
Hit?
Yeah, indeed. He could have used the baby dragon, the balloon, to clean up the final building, but he knew it didn't matter because even if he didn't get it, he got the two stars, which was the victory nonetheless. But we still have one final attack from Darkest Muzan going to be coming in. They're still want to put up another three star on the board. We are taking a look at the post attack stats. React, beautiful zap, ice Lalo using the ice hound, which to be honest, he didn't even need the freeze effect from it.
Flashing the V for victory and ready to drop the mic as soon as that battle was over. Well done, React. You have earned our respect and will be waiting in day two now to face off against Team Elevate. Surely going to be an awesome combat opportunity in the upper bracket for two teams that I think so far have just been head and shoulders above their competitors.
They really have. They've shined here today. And hey, the beautiful thing is we picked Top and I Empire to win, and they did indeed, which means we didn't jinx them for once. We have now the blimp coming in to help, coming with the Blizzard Dragons. Look at the chain value next to this Town Hall. Will the Super Wizards clear this compartment, drops another invis? Can they grab this Air Expo? That's going to be some nice value. Uses the final invisibility spell of the says that is worth it, and he clears a little bit of it. And the wizard tower goes down, so that is extra value.
Spreading things back out again and zooming out as we get ready for the second hit. The funnel has been a bit light so far over on this right side corner and going a little bit slower than I've been hoping for, but we've seen lightning fast finishes in the past. Will Manta be able to salvage something for Darkest Muzan and give them some hopes going into tomorrow? The lower bracket is going to be a fearsome place to have to fight from, but carry the flag high and march onward, Manta. Dragon's certain to swoop in now to see if he can get another triple for his squad.
He's trying to push with these dragons and dragon riders into the core. King's ability goes off, but he opens up the compartment near the multi on the left, which can help set the funnel, pushing them even deeper into the middle. The warden ability protects through one of the seeking air mines, saving onto this world champion, and he does decide to use a heal in the middle, but the eagle artillery is devastating, saving it for the back end of a base, trying to push his way through red air bombs. This is not looking too bad with this hero still pushing his way through.
Air mines popping up all over this map, though. Dragons really at low health and suffering mightily from a huge onslaught just firing away at them. Another big scatter shot now just about to pulverize this Electro Dragon. Finishes it off, and that is going to be a big hit on Manta's attack. He has been stung deep, and I don't know if he can survive this burn.
Oh, the Royal Champion is going to take down the MRC. Does not have her ability anymore. Eagle Artillery being saved for the final. But the thing is, no, Queen, the Eagle go down. It gets one, two, three shots off. Will it force the Queen ability? Let's keep right. One, two, and three. No,
oh,
the Queen saves onto her ability.
He's got
down
it.
Just a scatter. Hold. Wait, Queen. Come on, you can take it down. He's going to pop the ability early. The minion goes down to the scatter shot. Where's the ability? Oh, there it is. Come on, pop the Queen. Hopefully the scatter doesn't take her down.
Don't kill.
One,
oh, my God.
That... Two, no, there it is. Oh, the three star for Darkest Muzan, but it's not going to matter because Top and I Empire is walking away victorious. Dear